In 2010, the iPod Touch 4th generation was released, and it was the cool thing to have. If you didn't have the new iPod, you were simply uncool. Nothing more, nothing less. If you're not my age, I don't think you realize how important it was to have this thing. It was all I asked for Christmas. Okay, and a puppy, but that's it, I promise. And as I ripped my way through gifts that very Christmas morning, I didn't find a puppy. But what I did find is a fresh new iPod. I knew I could finally fit in with all my friends. I messaged them, FaceTime them, and even swipe my way through Temple Run. I quickly became addicted to this new piece of technology, and it became part of my everyday communication. Then around sixth grade, I had gotten my first phone, the iPhone 4S. And just up until a few months ago, I still owned the dinosaur. It had cracked so much that the screen had turned black. In hopes of the new iPhone 7, my mom decided to give me her old BlackBerry. I was not so happy about that, but what I didn't realize is that I was going to learn a lesson from this BlackBerry. And what I learned is the original purpose of a phone. And the original purpose of a phone is to call and or message, but that simple idea has advanced into a popular addiction. We go from memes to slime to even everyday, ever-changing trends of the 21st century. We invite our friends over only to find out everyone will be on their phones. And individuality is suffering for many of us. We hide behind the screen, conforming to social media, and it suffers for the future generations. Trying to be an individual when social media is all about gaining followers and likes, you'll never be genuine enough to do what you do. Trying through new things makes you an individual, but you will never be present enough in the moment if you have it for the intention of a like or a follow, and you'll never get all the gain that makes you an individual. I question if kids my age will ever do something without the intention of gaining a like or a follower, and it suffers for the future generations. A study, according to Indiana University by psychologists, says that when caregivers are focused on smartphones and technology, the children follow by example, and they get distracted, and they follow all the things that the parents are doing. When they're focused on their iPods, the kids are focused on their iPads. And when they are followers, they will never be present enough in the moment. When we have children, if we're not careful, they're gonna want to be our phones. They want to be held and looked at in the same way. So let's change this. Individuality is not easy. As Robert Frost has said, it's always easier to take the path already taken. But I came up here to talk to you all about how we can allow ourselves to non-conform and be an individual. So many of us came up here today to share our stories. My story is sailing and debate. You may think at first, what a weird combination, but all of us do kind of crazy things. So when people ask when I sail, I'll probably say something like, oh, it's really fun or it's really cool, but really it's physically straining and tiring. But the reason I sail is whenever I get on the water, my imagination is refreshed, and the people that sail are hilarious and inspiring to be with. And when people say, why do you debate? Or they most likely will think, what a nerd. I debate because when I learn so many new things, and when you debate across the nation, it's kind of see how interested people are in invested in Pakistan's government or Afghanistan's economic growth. Just last February, I went to Harvard with the debate team. I never thought I would debate at Harvard to debate amongst high schoolers across the nation, and I don't think my parents' wallet did either. But this is what allows me not to conform and to be an individual. And this is how I encourage you to do and try new things to make you an individual. So yes, I get beautiful sunset pictures when I sail and amazing snow photos at Harvard, but I don't let social media be my inspiration. Now, before I tell you guys what to do, I'm gonna make it clear that I'm not gonna be your mom today. I'm not gonna tell you to put your phone down. I'm not gonna tell you to go play outside. But what I am going to tell you is what social media is. Social media is made and to manipulate your thoughts and make you addicted to your phone or computer, to constantly check it. And I think that if you keep in mind that you are being manipulated, that you can put your phone down just for 1 minute. A study at UCLA equates that when you get the same brain sequences from winning the lottery or eating chocolate to getting addicted to your cell phone. So I urge you all today to put down your cell phones if you're thinking to just post something to be better than your friend, or to say, hey, I'm doing this, look how much fun I'm having. If that's why you're posting something, then put down your phone and realize that this is what social media is doing to you. Be an individual. Thank you.